गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम दर्शना मोरे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ फूड साइंस, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर, नासिक। टुडे वी विल सी अबाउट द कल्टीवेशन ऑफ ऑयल पाम। ऑयल पाम इज मोस्टली कल्टिवेटेड फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ऑयल। बोटेनिकल नेम ऑफ ऑयल पाम इज इलियस जुनेंसिस। द ऑयल पाम्स बिलोंग्स टू द फैमिली एरेकेसी। दे आर यूज इन कमर्शियल एग्रीकल्चर इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ऑयल। द ऑयल पाम tree originated from West Africa, where it was growing wild and later developed to the agriculture crops. The oil palm is a tropical palm tree. There are two species is better known. One is the one originated from Junia, Africa, and was first illustrated by Nicholas Jackman in 1763, hence its name as Ilias junensis. The other species of Ilias oleifera is native to tropical Central America and South America. This is the structure of oil palm. The mature tree are a single stem and grow up to the height 20 meter tall. The leaves are prominent and reach between 2 to 3 meter long. A young tree produces about 30 leaves in a year. Established tree over 10 years produce about 20 leaves per year. The oil palm is a crop that bears both male and female flowers on the same tree, meaning they are monoecious. The flowers are produced in dense cluster. Each individual flower is a small with 3 sepals and 3 petals. The trunk of young and adult plants are wrapped in fronds which gives them a rather rough appearance. The older trees have a smoother trunk apart from the scarf left by the fronds, which have withered and fallen off. Each tree produces compact bunches, tender, weighing between 20 to 25 kilograms, with 1000 to 3000 fruitlets per bunch. Each fruitlet is almost spherical and elongated in shape. Generally, the fruitlet is dark purple, almost black, and the color turns orange-red when ripe. In this picture, we can see the inner portion of oil palm. Each fruitlet consists of an oil, fleshy outer layer, that is pericarp, with a single seed, that is kernel, also rich in oil. The fruit take 5 to 6 months to mature from pollination to maturity. The normal oil palm tree will start bearing after 30 months of planting and will continue to be productive for the next 20 to 30 years, this ensuring a consistent supply of oil. Unlike the other relatives, the oil palm does not produce offshoot. Propagation is by sowing the seeds. In current scenario, the oil palm plantation in Malaysia are largely based on the estate management system and smallholder scheme. Today, over 4 million hectares of land in Malaysia is under oil palm cultivation, producing 15 million tons of palm oil in 2008. Malaysia is the largest producer and exporter of oil palm in the world, accounting for 34% of the world's trade edible oil and fat supply. In Malaysia, 11% of total land area, about 62% of the country's agricultural land, is devoted to palm oil. Worldwide palm oil production during the 2005 and 6 growing season was 39.8 million metric tons, of which 4.3 million ton was in the form of palm kernel oil. It is thus by far the most widely produced tropical oil and constitutes 34% of total edible oil production worldwide. In Malaysia, the tree planted are mainly the Tenera variety and the hybrid between Dura and Piscifera. The Tenera variety yields about 4 to 5 tons of crude palm oil per hectare, per year and about 1 ton of palm kernels. Climatic requirement for oil production, oil palm production, deep permeable soil, rich in humus content, and deep depth of should be at least 1 meter or less than 1 meter. Optimum pH 6.5 to 7.5. Avoid heavy soil with poor drainage, highly alkaline soil, and with more of gravels and sand with poor water holding capacity. Temperature requirement. Oil palm is recognized as a humid tropical palm. Sunlight. It is the sun loving plant and requires bright sunshine of more than 5 hours. Solar radiation below 350 calories centimeter square per day affects the growth and yield of the palm. Then the varieties of oil palm. There are three main varieties of oil palm, in which first is Dura, have a low to medium mesocarp, 35 to 55%, and it contains thick shell around the kernels. It is not preferred for the commercial cultivation. Shell thickness mesocarp 35 to 55%, 54% bites weight, and shell is 30% by the weight, kernel 60%, and shell thickness is 2 to 8 mm. Then Tenera variety, it is the hybrid Dura female and Pisifera male. It is Tenera variety, it is the cross of Dura and Pisifera. It is commercially and widely cultivated all over the world due to the high proportion of mesocarp, 60 to 95%. It is characterized by the presence of thin shell. Tenera is characterized by the presence of distinct ring of fibers embedded in the mesocarp near to and the encircling the seeds. Tenera fruits have a lot of pulp, thin shell and big kernel. Mesocarp 60 to 95% and 74% by its weight. Shell 10% and kernel 16%. Then Pisifera variety. It is the shell-less fruit and pea-like kernel inside. Abortion is the common in this variety and often kernel is absent. The presence or absence of shell is genetically controlled. Dura is a genetic constitution of SH plus SH, while Pisifera is SH minus SH, and the hybrid is SH plus SH. On the selfing or intercrossing, the hybrid fruits forms segregate into 25% of Dura and 50% of Tenera and 25% of Pisifera. The mesocarp is 95% by weight and kernel is 10%. It is noted that the Pisifera seed propagation is not possible as many of the fruit do not have an embryo. Embryo abortion is common in this variety and often kernel is also absent. It is used as a male parent in the production of Tenera. Pisifera palms are generally recovered from segregating population since direct reproduction of this type is difficult due to the scarcity of fruits with embryo and the absence of protective shell. Features differentiating fruit types of oil palm. First, characteristics, consumption, then varieties, different varieties. First one, mesocarp proportion in fruit. 13 Dura 35 to 50%, Tenera 60 to 96%, and Pisifera 98%. Shell thickness in mm, 2 to 8 mm, and in Tenera 0.5 to 4 mm. Oil percentage 15% in Dura, 36% in Tenera, and 25% in Pisifera. The average proportion of shell in a fruit percent 30% in Dura, and the shell proportion in Tenera is 10%. The average proportion of kernel in a fruit 16% in Dura and 16% in Tenera. Type of progeny is a result of Dura cross Pisifera, then Dura cross Dura, and Tenera cross Tenera. Then propagation in oil palm, methods and system of planting. Germination period in oil palm is under natural condition. It takes about 2 years for germination in oil palm, and mode of propagation is seed propagation. Commercial propagation is seed. Then planting and after care planting. Season of planting is May to June. System of planting generally square and triangular system of planting are used, but most of commercially used is the triangular system. Age and stage of seedling at the time of planting, 10 to 14 month. Sometimes 12 to 18 month old seedlings are used for transplanting. At this stage, the seedling will have 13 leaves and about 1 to 1.30 meter in height with good collar girth. Pit size for planting 60 by 60 by 60 centimeter and the spacing is 9 by 9 meter. It accommodates about 140 to 150 per trees per hectare in a triangular system of planting or 10 by 10 meter. Fill the pits with FYM plus topsoil and plus 125 gram of phosphorus. Seedling are protected from rodents whenever necessary by wire netting encircling at the radius of 15 cm from the base. Take care of maintenance during initial period of establishment. Then manuring and fertilizers. First manuring, FYM 50 kg per palm per year or 50 to 100 kg. 100 kg of green manure, neem cake, additional of neem cake at the rate 5 kg per palm is beneficial. Then fertilizer dose, fertilizer is applied in two split doses. First is May-June, that is pre-monsoon season, and post-monsoon September-October. Then fertilizers, age of plants and application of fertilizers according to the age of plants. In the first year, 200 gram of NPK, 200, 100 and 200 gram of NPK applied in the pre-monsoon season, May-June, and remaining dose is applied in post-monsoon season, that is 200, 200 and 125. Magnesium sulfate is also applied as a micronutrient. Then in second year, 400, 200, 400 in the pre-monsoon season, and remaining 400, 400, 400 and 250 gram of NPK applied in post-monsoon season. 3 years and onwards, 600, 300, 600 applied in a pre-season, pre-monsoon season, and remaining 600, 600 and 500 gram of NPK plus magnesium sulfate applied in a post-monsoon season. Full dose for the adult palm, including 1200 gram of N, 600 gram of phosphorus and 1200 gram of potassium per year. Deficiencies of micronutrients in oil palm is magnesium and boron deficiency has been observed in oil palm. Magnesium deficiency, olive green colored appears on the leaves, on the pinna of folded leaves, and yellow color spreads down towards the front midrib until the whole pinna becomes a deep orange color. This is the symptoms of magnesium deficiency. Magnesium deficiency occurs due to the heavy application of potassic fertilizer. When the ratio is K:M exceeds 5. And next one is boron deficiency, hook leaves, or it is also termed as blind leaf and also bristle leaves. Apply 75 to 100 gram of borax, sodium borate per palm. We can also use sulfur for the foliar spray at the rate 0.1%. Note, supply magnesium at the rate 500 gram per palm per year if deficiency symptoms are noticed. Borax at the rate 100 gram of per palm per year if boron deficiency is observed. Under the irrigated condition, it is preferable to apply nitrogenous and potassic fertilizer as many splits as possible to increase the fertilizer use efficiency. Then method of fertilizer application in oil palm is, fertilizer is applied at the base of the palm, leaving 1 to 2 feet basal area undisturbed. depth of application 1 to 2 inches and mix with soil. Basin management, size of the palm basin in oil palm. Widen the basin as when tree grows. First year planting 1 meter radius, second year planting 2 meter radius, third meter radius. Basin space must be meant only for the oil palm and should be free from weeds and any intermixed crops. Note, spread fertilizers in the ring underneath the largest leaves and after spreading over the thin layer of soil. If the plants are mulched, remove the mulching material and spread the fertilizer and spread the fresh mulch of dry herbage to a thickness of 15 to 20 centimeter. Okay, thank you.